Hello, this is a tutorial on how to connect your VtubeStudio app from your iPhone to VBridger. For this, we'll be using three things: the VtubeStudio app on the iPhone, VtubeStudio for the computer from Steam, and VBridger, which is also available on Steam. First, let's make sure that your VtubeStudio app has the proper permissions for the connection. In your iPhone settings, scroll all the way down to the apps and find VtubeStudio. Make sure that local network is enabled. Next, hop onto the computer version of VtubeStudio and go to the gear icon for the settings. Scroll down to the connection settings and make sure Start Server is toggled on. Take note of the port number and the IP in the IP list. These numbers will be entered on the VtubeStudio phone app in a second. While you're in this menu, scroll down a little bit more to the plugin section and make sure that Start API is toggled on. This is necessary for the connection to VBridger. Now, return to your iPhone and open the VtubeStudio app. Click on the gear icon and scroll down a little to the Stream to PC Wi-Fi section. Using the port and IP we noted down in the last step, insert them accordingly to the corresponding box. You'll know that you entered them correctly once the status indicator is green and your model is moving on the computer version of VtubeStudio. Once done, scroll down to the bottom and find the third-party PC client section and make sure that Activate Toggle is on. Before we enter VBridger, we need to get your iPhone's IP address. Go to your iPhone settings and click on the Wi-Fi section. Click on the Wi-Fi that your iPhone is currently connected to and scroll down to find the IP address. Take note of this number sequence. Please note that my VBridger layout likely does not look like yours as this is the editor DLC, but the process is the same. The base version looks a little like this and everything we need is located in the same area. With that said, onto VBridger. You can find a section on the bottom that says Enter iPhone IP Address. Insert the IP address you just noted from your iPhone Wi-Fi settings. Since we are using VtubeStudio as the tracker, make sure the adjacent dropdown is set to VtubeStudio. Once that is set, press Connect to iPhone. If everything was entered correctly, the example model at the top should begin to move. Now, look at the bottom right of the VBridger window where there is a mini VtubeStudio icon. It should show in the adjacent box that VtubeStudio is available. Press Connect. If this is your first time connecting, it will open a prompt asking for permission for VBridger to connect. Press Allow. Now, you've successfully connected to VBridger. If you don't have a model with VBridger rigging and would like to try it, there is an official VBridger sample model that I will link in the description. My name is Universe Cat, and I hope this helped. Bye-bye.